So here I have a needle. So it looks almost identical to the other needle I have in my Tupperware over here. So if I remember exactly how this needle looks like and I throw it into the bunch, how are you gonna find exact copy of it in the most efficient way? And how do I find the second match and third match and so on and so forth? So in reality, my channel mostly talks about bioinformatics and molecular biology. If you actually drop your grandmother's precious needle into a haystack situation like this, it might be a little bit more complicated than that. So rather than looking for a needle in a haystack in bioinformatics, most of the time we are actually looking for, let's say, a single needle in a swimming pool of needle, similar to the scene that we have seen in Saw 2, the movie. Terrible movie, don't look at it, but it's okay. So just for some background information on NGS and how does this actually fall into the context of, you know, looking for a needle in a haystack. So due to the limitation in our sequencing technology, we have a long number of genome, but the sequencing technology are unable to read things one by one by one by one. So just for analogy, if you have a genetic sequence that are, let's say, 100,000 base pair long, we are not able to sequence one by one by one by one over 100,000 length, because that would take a ridiculous amount of time and will introduce a lot of errors. Certain technology are trying to achieve that, but they're still very slow. So the current fastest method where we do is called Soxella sequencing, or the Illumina technology. It's trying to break this big sequence into really, really short chain. So what they do is that they break them into maybe 150 to 250 to maybe 350 base pair into very, very short chain, okay? So you have a bunch of this that is, of course, jumbled up. You do not know the sequence of one, another, another, another. So what we do is that instead of reading it in serial, where we read one by one by one, one length continuously for a long amount of time, we give all of them into, let's say, a million different people and ask each of them to memorize the sequence and then give us that 100 million different sequence back to us, and we try to put together into an assembly software, and the assembly software will try to give us one big pieces. However, if you have really do a puzzle before, the process of piecing all this thing together takes a ridiculous amount of time and computing power, and most of the time we are not able to get one big pieces back due to, you know, lack of information in certain situation, or, you know, lack of overlapping sequence that we need to actually map one thing to another. So what we usually have instead of the full sequence that we have over here, and this is actually four long sequence over here, we will usually have a much shorter sequences. So of course, it's not going to be as short as this, you know, because I'm doing it manually over here, so I'm not able to give you the full length of every situation. And of course, the sequence that we got on the database would not be this short. They're usually a few thousand kilobase pair to 100,000 kilobase pair. A few thousand base pair to 100 kilo base pair. So something like that. But give you an analogy that even when we have just a few thousand of them over here and a few, like 10 or 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So there's just 15 base pair of it. How are you going to make sure that these four fragments that we get from our sequencing result, where do they come from and what is the location that they are? So in this case, this will be in a situation of RNA sequencing. The mRNA, you want to know the location of the mRNA on the genome, or you want to know the actual sequence in the transcriptome. So this is what you do with BLAST. Finally, you know, the word of BLAST coming in. Okay, so the traditional way of how you can try to identify a sequence of a nucleotide is to actually map to the frame one by one. So what we can do here is to just see if this match up. It doesn't. Move over one slot, it doesn't match. Move over the other one slot, it doesn't match. So if you do this across, you will eventually find a match. But if we can see just now, just by doing this one by 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 one, blah, 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 blah. So it's ridiculously slow and ridiculously inefficient. And if you're going to do this with a sequencing run which generate hundreds and millions of this, you're going to take like until the end of the universe to actually try to, you know, annotate your sequence. So it's gonna take a lot of time. And if you only have four into four, I at least gonna take, let's say half an hour for me to try to make it back. Yes, a computer can run things a lot faster than us, maybe a few hundred times faster than us, but you know, a few billion years, a hundred times faster than a few billion years is still a few hundred million years, and it's, yeah, don't quote me on the mathematics, you know, my mental math is not that good. But you get the point, it's gonna take a long amount of time just to annotate them. So this is where a BLAST is kind of invented or mentioned. So remember, this is in 1990s. BLAST is first described by the scientists in 1990s as has been one of the most widely used algorithm for such annotation purposes. So what BLAST does is actually very, very simple. So instead of actually matching the whole strain over the whole length, which is maybe a few thousand base pair, what we can do is to randomly select maybe 7 to 11 of them, just a nice number, so that the parameter can be choose in your BLAST menu. That's actually called a seed size. So what they call this is a seed. So here we have 4 nucleotide sequences, just for an example. So this is actually, I don't know if you can see this, I don't think you can see, it's TAAA, if you can see that. Okay, so what we try to do is to, on this big genome, we just try to fish out where does TAAA appear. So a 3 triple A. So if you scan it down the sequence over here, you can find there's a 3 triple A here. And if you can find triple A, triple A, triple A, 1, 2, 3, there's another 3 triple A over here and here. And 3, 2, A, da, 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 da. So you can already see this sequence. The method of doing this is already a lot faster because, first of all, the memory footprint is very low. You don't have to, you know, try to memorize the whole sequence, and that means a lot lower RAM usage in terms of computing. And also, it's a lot easier for the computer to look for short sequence. It's a lot faster. And, you know, let's say, okay, so we have identified TAAA over here. So then what does BLAST do is to extend the seed over here. So the first seed we found is TAAA. I'm not sure you can see this. I think I'm sure it's kind of small. But then what they do is that they'll extend the seed on both sides. So you see this is a G over here. A C over here. This is a G. So that's a mismatch, minus mark. Okay, so you see this is a T, this is a G, both sides is wrong, almost all the marks get minus. Let's move on to the second seed, shall we? So if you see this here, it's a TAAA, exact match. You see a T, this is a G, and a C, and a C, and a C. So this is correct, so we have a 5 seed situation here. But you see this is a C, G, a T, so that's a minus mark. You got 2 mismatch already. You can continue on, which the normal BLAST will actually do that. So, and they'll give you a final sequence similarity index. But I'm not gonna do it here. I'm gonna move on to my third seed over here. Okay, so you look at this. So you got TAAA, TAAA, you got a GCTAT. So GCTAT. So here you can see there's a sequence similarity of 100%. So most likely that this fragment that you found belongs to sequence 2 over here. So if you do the rest of it, here I have 4 sequences and I have 4 short fragments. And of course, I do not actually do this in real time. I already map it out. You can see there's a number here. So you can just look at this sequence. Let's see if I can zoom in a little bit for you. So this is AGGG. So we can just look for AGGG in the sequence. So I can already see, you can find here, there's an AGGG here. Okay, so you can find one over here. So you extend the seed size. So for this, and you will find the matches. So let's move for the next one. We have a CTAA. Let me just zoom in this again. So CTAA. So let's just go to the sequence and find where we can find a CTAA. So CTAA over here. So you can TTGGAACTAAGC. So by looking at short sequences and trying to extend them, not only we are able to find things a lot faster and a lot more straightforward way, we are also able to try to memorize, remember the one we do just now, where there's a number 1, number 2, and number 3. So you're able to rank them from one to another. So you are not only able to find the most closest match, you're also able to find the subsequent closest match onto until, let's say, usually they give out 20 of them, so you're able to determine that which is the closest match that you have. So the last sequence over here, let's go for something easier for us to memorize, GCCA, if you can see here, GCCA. So in this case, the generation of such seed are usually random, so we do not know which one will be able, which seed the computer algorithm will actually chooses. So this is actually what we call a heuristic algorithm, where it's kind of a greedy algorithm, so that if you rerun the whole thing the second time, sometimes you might not get exactly the same outcome. The outcome might change here. They might change slightly, but for the time that we are able to save from doing this kind of seed setting and try to extend it, we are able to find whatever we need into a from a much bigger database a lot faster. I believe it's almost a magnitude faster compared to what we would have done manually, which is like mapping of the genome and all that, and so on and so forth. So the next time you actually think about how you can actually find a small fragment into the whole book, you might be able to use this mathematical algorithm, and instead of looking for the whole sentence directly, you try to look for certain keywords and try to extend on this the either side and see if you are able to get a match. And you get a match, you remember that will be your seed, and hopefully that will be your outcome. So I hope you learned something. I definitely did today. So thank you for watching. Breakfast for a Living.